So lately then, this bike's been suffering with the classic crankcase pressure sensor issues. But I've managed to get my bike from sounding like this to sounding like this. Now, if that sounds like your bike and you're having the same issue, grab your favorite cleaning kit before you start spending any money, because what you're gonna do is you're gonna get the bike undone and you're gonna clean your sensors. If you've not been near these sensors before, you need to start off by removing the air filter cover. That will then give you access to the single screw that holds the seat on. Remove the screw, slide the seat back. You may have to hit it a couple of times to get it to move. And then you put the screw back in the seat to make sure you don't lose it. When you get to your fuel tank, then there's a screw in the center of the fuel tank on the top. Then once that's done, you can move to either side of the shrouds. You've got two on the right side shroud, which is the right hand side of the radiator, and then two on the left hand side of the radiator. There's three short screws and one long screw. The one long screw holds the horn. Once those four screws are removed, you've got the electrical connector for the fuel level reader, and you've also got the fuel connection as well on the left hand side of the bottom, and then you can remove your fuel tank. Once that's removed, you've got access to the left hand side of the bike, which is where your crankcase pressure sensor is. You can actually get your ambient pressure sensor without the need of removing your tank, but it is a bit tight. So now you're down to the sensors, then you've got to remove two screws. Both of them have a screw holding them in. Those screws are T25 Torx, so try and use a sort of ratchet spanner if you can. That'll make things so much easier because of how little room there is to maneuver inside. Once you've got the sensors off, give them a check over, make sure there's no cracks or anything, any obvious damage. You'll see that they are stinking. You need to get that dirt off. Just give it a wipe down, make sure no cleaning fluid or anything goes inside the hole. Once that's done, keep them aside because you're going to start cleaning the tray that houses them. So you can see with this part here, this is the ambient air temperature side. It's pretty dirty in there, to be fair. So I've given that a clean out, got the dirt out. And now we're going to move on to the pipe that comes out the back of the cylinder head. So once you get to the pipe, then you're just going to remove this little clip here, and then you'll be able to pull this off. This is quite tough to get off. And this one here is where the little brass screw is that you'll need the deep 8mm socket for. So you're going to give the brass screw a good cleaning, both inside and out, and also the little black pipe before putting them back together. So you can now grab your sensors that you've set aside, and before you put them back in the tray that they came out of, rub some grease around these rubber little O-rings here in this picture. Basically, that'll hopefully give you a better seal and stop any more crap falling into them anytime soon. From there, you can start assembling your bike, which is pretty much the reversal of what you did to get to the sensors to begin with initially. And once that's done, then you put your bike back together, start the bike up, have a listen. Fingers crossed it sounds a lot better than it did. And if your bike sounds better than it did before, then that bit of work you've just done has paid off and you haven't paid a penny for anything new. Going forward, I hope this does help a lot of people out. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate, put them in the comment section and I'll do my best to help out where I can. I'm going to call it a day there. Thanks very much for watching.